pandemic has exposed much about life here in the U.S., including our reliance on undocumented workers in essential jobs. Paul Solman explores what's at stake for his latest report for Making Sense.
In affluent Mount Kisco, a New York City suburb, undocumented immigrants for hire. At the train station, at Henry's Deli, and at Neighbors Link, a nonprofit that serves the newly arrived. They line up at 7, contractors, even just homeowners like Tony Archie soon follow.
Trees came down on my property, so I want to move the firewood from one side of the house to the other.
And he's spreading mulch, a two-person job for which only one worker was available.
He's 17 of the hours today.
How many hours is he going to work? Cuantos horas?
In the end, no deal. Pool company owner Chris Carthy, also out of luck.
There's a labor shortage across the country.
Even at Neighbors Link?
I come here every blue moon to pick up those extra few hands for excavation, and we can't get anyone.
And so the nub of the economic argument for letting some 11 million undocumented immigrants already in the U.S. remain legally.
So let's just be clear that immigrants are coming to this country because of our thirst for this workforce.
Carola Bracco runs Neighbors Link.
They are taking on jobs that often complement the workforce that was born in this country because of the fact that they're willing to do these jobs.
Jobs in agriculture, construction, landscaping, cleaning, and who's busing tables at restaurants, washing dishes, cooking?
This is the apron with the logo.
This man, whom we've decided not to name, has worked in restaurants for 20 years since slipping across the desert from Mexico.
A couple restaurants in Manhattan. Also, I used to work in the airport, JFK.
Catering for American Airlines. In 2008, he moved up to Trump National Westchester Golf Club.
Were there many other undocumented people in the club?
A lot. I would say 30% of the employees, maybe more. In the grounds, kitchen, wait staff, maintenance, we're pretty much all over the club, illegal people.
Did people know that you were undocumented? The people who hired you?
Yeah, they know.
How do you know they know?
This is the card that I told me this is too fake for accepted.
How could they not have known, he says, given that they noted the obvious inauthenticity of his ID?
So I gotta get another one. I gotta spend another $45.
Both bought on the street from people hawking fake IDs.
All you have to give is the picture, and they do the rest.
Now, this man lost his job at Trump National Westchester in 2019 after news reports that the club had hired undocumented immigrants. At the time, Eric Trump said the company planned to check workers' status in the future. But in his decade at the club, this worker had risen to banquet chef, selfieing with the likes of baseball legends Pedro Martinez and Mariano Rivera, and earning as much as $70,000 a year between the club and odd winter jobs.
Couldn't they have found citizens to work for that kind of money?
I guess no, because it was days that I started 6 in the morning and I was in the club until like midnight, nonstop. So I guess not everybody do that. And sometimes I was mad, of course, because this is too much. But at the same time, I feel like I got my hands tied. If I say something, they might be fire me, they might say something, you know, to the authorities, ICE in this case.
Because you're always at risk, yes?
Yes. We are in risk every day.
So, economic argument number one, the undocumented do jobs nobody else will. Okay, another point, somewhere between 50 and 75% of undocumented workers pay taxes, says the nonpartisan Congressional Budget Office.
I got all the taxes that I've been paying since I'm in this country, since 2002 until 2020. I got to pay taxes like a normal person, like a person with documents.
So they contribute to the economy in production and in taxes, which pay for benefits that the undocumented can't always use.
Medicare, Section 8, they don't qualify for food stamps, a whole variety of services that they don't qualify for.
Undocumented immigrants provide yet another economic advantage for those worried about Social Security's finances.
So you paid Social Security?
Yes. every single year since day one.
Will you get Social Security when you get older?
I don't think so, because no documents, no Social Security.
There is a large fund that the Social Security Administration has that are benefits that will never be paid out to the people that paid the funds in.
So that's pretty much the case for legalizing the undocumented. The case against?
Illegal immigrants clearly cost taxpayers far more in benefits than they pay in taxes.
Isn't it time for Washington to prioritize the American people?
Dan Stein, who runs the Federation for American Immigration Reform, insists that the undocumented do not pay for themselves. When you consider, for example,
the social safety net, the cost of the social safety net, education, public schooling.
Worse still, he says, they drive down wages.
The percent of Americans in the labor force is at an all-time low. One of the reasons is systemic illegal immigration. Employers prefer to hire illegal immigrants over American citizens because they're pliable. They'll do menial jobs for very low wages. They prefer them.
But I talk to employers all over the country, and they say we cannot find people to do the jobs we need to have done. That's not true.
Employers are constantly crying that they have a labor shortage. Why? Because employers like the labor market dynamics of hiring illegal labor.
I put Stein's argument to Carola Bracco of Neighbors Link.
Isn't there a good argument that undocumented immigrants drive down wages?
Wage theft is actually the big issue as it relates to undocumented immigrants.
But regardless, she says,
if there weren't undocumented immigrants doing this work, employers wouldn't be able to find anybody to do that work.
And if you deported them,
you would find a significant reduction in our economy. What we've basically done is created a second-class citizen that is ripe for abuse and exploitation. I think we need to rectify that issue and bring in immigration reform.
Reform that would legalize the undocumented, that is. But to Dan Stein, that would
justify lawbreaking and illegality. Employers have an obligation, like everyone else, to respect the law. It's a cornerstone of citizenship.
The kind of citizenship to which Trump National's former banquet chef aspires. But he did break the law, which raised a final question.
How come you feel comfortable talking to me like this?
I'm not 100% comfortable, but somebody's got to say something. And hopefully Mr. Biden saw this interview and give us a chance. Why not? I guess that's the whole reason, to show every single American that we're not a bad people. We try to be good. And thanks to this country, I think we do.
For the PBS NewsHour, Paul Solman.